Tell me, do you feel slightly uncomfortable sat where you are right now?
A very strange, negative deja vu feeling coming over me now, mate.
Why is that, mate?
Because last Wednesday I happened to be next to you at the Glebe, David Hall's memorial match.
And what a great match it was.
It was awesome, wasn't
it? Fitting tribute to David.
A man who got us both into the angling trade, gave us our chance really, didn't he? And
he certainly played a big part in both of our careers to date, hadn't he? So,
wouldn't be sat here doing this without him, would we, probably?
Absolutely not. But yeah, the match was fished in his memory. We drew on late four.
Next to each other.
We did. You were on the end peg, weren't you, mate?
End peg in a corner, wind blowing out of it. Absolutely terrible peg.
Sorry, Paul. I said it was a good peg, mate.
Fantastic. And how did you catch?
I caught slowly and not very much.
But I said not very much, Tom. I weighed 150
pounds. You can't say you didn't catch very much.
It
was brilliant. I had 150 pounds.
I loved it. I had a lovely day's fishing. Really enjoyed it. Caught plenty of fish. Caught on corn short. But I tried to catch down the margins later on because you, next to me, started catching some big fish a couple of hours to go down the edge. And I couldn't catch them. I didn't catch anything down the edge. So, looking back, and when we first met.
Yeah,
I should have just fished down, I should have fished short pole down that first bit of shelf on the hard bottom with corn all day and just plugged away, kept putting fish in the net.
But instead I went chasing these fish down the edge that I don't think were really there.
You say you should have plugged away. I don't think there's any pike in there.
No. What I mean
plugs wouldn't be any good.
I mean, carried on fishing. Short,
sorry, mate. You know. Sorry, I misunderstood you there. Right. Sorry, Paul.
It's all right, Paul. But, hey, it was good. It wasn't too serious. We enjoyed it.
We were awesome.
Tell me about your match. You caught some lovely fish.
Yeah, again, I caught short. But the stamp of fish on the short pole and come were quite small. The Glebe, and I just had a feeling that Lake One would produce a big, big weight as it did.
Yeah.
And so I didn't really feel that, even though I was catching quite a lot of fish short, there were sort of pound, 2 pound, 3 pound fish. I thought, we had a lot of these to do well. So, about halfway through the match, I decided that I was really going to make the edge my priority. But I fed quite aggressively with ground, but I fed a little bit deeper water than I would do normally, so 2.5 to 3 foot of water probably. Which puts you about a metre and a half off the bank there, but I've often found on venues like the Glebe, if you fish a little bit further away, alright, you've got to fish a heavier rig, you've got to be very careful how you put your rig in and how you do it, because there's obviously the danger of how looking fish, but you catch the bigger stamp fish than you do if you fish right next to the bank. And then, I caught some good stamp fish later on, £190, which was only good enough to win the lake. It was probably 10th overall or 9th overall, I think.
No. 12th, 13th, £200 were
9th. Was it really?
Yeah.
12th or 13th overall, but Lake One fished its absolute brains out. The pick of the crop was dead ship.
£330, Lake One about, I think we were about peg 15, something like that.
We've got a nice little interview with him, aren't we, a bit later, but interesting
how he fished.
Very interesting.
He fished soft pellets out in open water, something that probably no one else on the match did. And then he fished corn down the edge, but he fished like the other side of this grass stump down the margin. He loose fed a bit of corn, potted a bit of corn in, and
I think he went down the edge with like 2 hours to go and emptied it.
Brilliant. He's just that kind of fish here. I don't think there's an angler in the country who's as good as he is.
Best in the world, at it, that's it. Quite clearly.
Yeah. So you would fancy to push him close now? Controversial statement coming up.
The power.
Yeah. Andy Power. I think Andy Power's getting there.
Yeah.
I'll tell you who really impressed me though on that match. Really impressed me. Our new signing, Jake Fells.
The new boy.
The new boy. He's joined the match fishing and pole fishing team. Lovely lad from the Northwest, isn't he?
Yeah.
Got a very, very good looking twin sister.
And girlfriend, might we add.
Yes. Yeah, his twin sister's not his girlfriend, just to clear that up.
Yeah.
He's got a very good looking girlfriend and
a very good looking twin sister.
A very good looking twin sister as well. So, yes, he's certainly of great interest to us, isn't it?
Fantastic, isn't it? He can come and stay over whenever he wants.
Absolutely, absolutely. But no, he did brilliantly. He caught £258, was it?
Something like that, yeah.
£258, I think.
He was fourth on the match.
Just an awesome performance.
Beat Lee Perry by a pound.
He did. Were you next to Lee?
No, two away, but he did beat you.
Well, it's as good as being next to him, isn't it?
Yeah, of course it is. Well, Andy Kinder were between them. He's only little, so it's like being next to him.
Yeah, you could have seen her straight up at the top, wouldn't
you? Yeah, of course.
I'll tell you what I did like, which brought back some good memories of David all this week. I was showing Jake, I was talking to Jake about writing, and obviously we write the features, and I explained how often you have to paraphrase what anglers say, and very often, you know, you sort of speak their words for them, if that makes sense. You go out, you get a
make
feel.
Make it up.
Not make it up, but you go out, you get a feel for what they're on about, and then you write it down. I always remember David Hall telling me a great story about this. And apparently once he wrote this feature, he just got something slightly wrong, which is always a danger when you do our job. And he said something slightly differently to how the angler he was writing about wanted it said. And this bloke's running him up and he says, David, I've just seen this feature in the magazine. He said, you've said I've said this. And I never said that at all. So David, in his usual quick-witted way, replied, well, you would have if you were clever enough. Can't get a better comeback.
No, you can hear him saying it, can't you?
Yeah. So that was David Hall's match. Lovely match. Made some good money for cancelling the chase as well.
Yeah.
So, brilliant. And then on Friday, it was the Drennan Knockout Cup, first round, wasn't it?
An exciting match, 146 anglers, 143 anglers, batting it out for 60 places at Toolbarn Farm in Warwickshire. Most of us fished, didn't we? Me, you, Joe Crass, all from the Match and Poaching team. And we all made it through to the next round.
We did.
How was your match?
It was an interesting day. I drew a peg. I quite fancied peg 16 on high pull.
Yeah.
Now, obviously, you'll remember that.
Yeah,
you're right,
mate. You're
up, Pop. I know, mate. You're up, Pop. Carry on. Sorry, mate. Yeah, you remember that, in the last blog we did, we spoke about our open match there last weekend, and peg 16 was actually the peg that Paul Bick won the lake off.
Right.
So, I did quite fancy it. But, peg 15 is historically the flyer.
Yeah.
And guess who were on that next to me?
I know who were on it, you've told me already.
Go on.
Jam and Jelly.
Yeah, Frankie Garnicello was on peg 15. And I thought, I don't know whether I fancy beating him today. He just looked like he was on it.
He's good at commercial fishing, isn't he?
He's not bad, is he?
He's very good.
But obviously that doesn't matter because all we're trying to do was catch a weight. I thought you need 70 to 80 pounds to qualify, so my target was to catch 70 pounds. And I actually fished quite a safe match, which I don't regret as it's turned out, because I did enough to sneak through. But I fished meat short and worms across to the island. I was going to fish shallower casters. I just thought, there's always a danger when you start blasting bait about. You know, you pull fish all over and you can't ever pin them down. And especially when it's tightly pegged and you're not sure how good it's going to be. So I was just a little bit reserved about doing that.
Right.
It's a crossing short. And I know it's going to sound weird, because again, I had a great day's fishing. I had 73 pounds. It was quite hard. I couldn't seem to line any number of fish up on any line. It was sort of catch a couple, go back across. You know, and I just basically nick fish all day. 73 pound. I was second in my section. Frankie won the section. He had 95 pound. He had a similar match to me, Frankie, but he's just had a golden spell of probably an hour and a half, 2 hours in the middle of the match where he's absolutely clattered and he's had one chuck shallow. But you've got so much water on peg 15, you know, that you can do that, can't you? So. Anyway, how was your day?
I had a lovely day fishing, Thomas. I said to you earlier, I've been quite frustrated with my commercial fishing recently because. Been beat off next peg a few times by yourself. Lee Wright beat us off next peg last week. And the same happened in the Drennan on Friday. Drew next Andy May. I got Ben Roberts one side, Welsh international, lovely lad. And Andy May the other side, absolute nutter. Love him to bits. He's one of my favourite people in angling.
He's a definitely. Good egg.
And we were on extension pool. I think we're on peg 28 or something like that, 28, 29. I had an interesting match. I started short on pellets, caught a few fish dead quickly, first 15, 20 minutes. And then I thought, based on what I learnt last week about fishing across, when I said I should have fished across most of the day, I thought, I'm going to do that. Started in like 3.5 foot of water, caught a few there, an odd big F1, odd skimmer. Gone a little bit further across as the day's worn on, 2.5 foot of water, not very good, caught an odd one. And at that point, when I realised perhaps a cross wasn't going to be good, I started loose feeding casters down the middle. So I thought, I've got a feeling that's not going to be a great way to fish. I want somewhere else to go that's quite positively fed to give myself a weight boost. And 2.5 foot across, weren't very good. Caught a few, an odd little F1 and an odd skimmer, and then start catching little perch and stuff, which is always a giveaway sign that it's not happening. Went right across into the shallow water about 2 hours in. No good whatsoever.
And I've ended up coming in onto these casters that I've been firing down the middle, dead positive, and I've caught an odd fish shallow. So for like the last, well, for the
third and fourth hour of the match, I've caught an odd big F1 shallow and an odd fish across, just alternating between, and kept myself in it kind of thing. And then last sort of hour of the match, things have really died, and I've ended up nicking an odd one on meat down the edge, throwing a little bit of meat down the edge, last off, and caught a few fish down there, and ended with £89, which was enough for second in the section, behind Andy May. Andy had £104, and he basically fished shallow, back to front, fished two lines, both shallow.
Back to front? Did it sit backwards on his back?
Yeah.
Really?
Upside down and all at one point.
He's good, it's good, but I didn't know that good.
Chucked a cartwheel in halfway through.
Did he really?
Yeah, three or four ooshes. I did give him one of my cheese and onion sandwiches before the start.
That might have given him
well, one. I thought, that'll just, if he starts catching me, I'll just keep him nice and slowed down, because I'm getting a little sandwich. Did it heck?
No, spend him up, didn't he? Yeah. Can eat that lad.
He can. He did brilliant, though. He had £104. He just fished shallow down the middle and also across.
And won the section. But
It was enough to qualify, £89. Good day's fishing, learnt a little bit, and I enjoyed it.
And the match winner did rather well, didn't he?
Big well done. I love him.
He's a lovely kid, and he's always been a brilliant angler. As long as I can remember, he's been a brilliant angler.
He's a proper angler and all. He's a right character. He grew up with Dennis White in Barnsley. He'd tell you anything. He's just a proper nice kid.
Lovely lad.
Awesome at fishing.
He is. And Dale Shepherd, he won the... won the match, didn't he? Yeah, £129 from House Peg 33, I think he was.
Yeah.
Just a brilliant.
Got worms across, which were interesting.
Very interesting. So that was Drennan round one, as Matt said. Luckily we're through to round two on the New Junction Canal in July, so...
should be a nice match, actually.
Definitely looking forward to it. And then on to Partridge Lakes, wasn't it, on Saturday?
It was, the Maver match this qualifier. We both went, didn't we? Over the Pennines, from Sheffield over to Manchester, or Warrington.
We did, and I've never fished Partridge Lakes before. I've been there on a feature before with Andy Bennett, and I've done some videos there, but I've never actually fished a match there. And I really, really enjoyed the day. I drew Covey 2, peg 41, which means nothing to me. Spoke to Andy May before the start, and he said, not very good. He didn't sound very positive.
Didn't he?
I thought, oh dear. Right. But I thought I'll do what I do. I started off short. I've caught a few left ones, but it weren't great. A lot of like false indications, and you know. And I've had a couple of big carp move with the peg. I thought, we've got some big fish here. So I've gone across. I'm just kind of part of some bait. I'm getting indications on the front. I thought, there's definitely some big clever F1s in the peg here. I can't catch them. I'm only fishing like 011 power line, so it's not like I'm fishing heavy, but just got confident across the rig, and that's probably slightly heavier than I would normally fish, but only because I've got some stick-ups. I thought, we can go straight through them. But anyway, I thought, I'm going to have to scale down and just try it. If I scale down to 010, nothing. I'm still getting these like this. I put the bait in. I'm thinking, there's definitely some bigger forms here. So I've come back, I've set a new rig up, a 0.1 gram rig, the strung number 11s, an 08 hookworm, a 16 black gamma, and a single caster. I thought, at least I'll find out what's there. Might not get them in, but I'll find out. You know what I had? Two carp in two chucks. £1.8, £1.6. Thought, you clever bugger. I was convinced there were F1s that were there. One of them both, though, it came in okay. And I thought, right, now we'll catch them. Never had another bite there, I don't think, until the last 20 minutes, and I had one more carp.
Oh, no.
I know. Had a few F1s short, though. I ended up with £48, second in the section. £60 in the section. But yeah, you had a similar day, didn't you, mate? A bit more weight, but similarly frustrating.
Yeah, it was frustrating. I tell you what, I drew peg 10 on Covey 1 and the wind were off my back. And I when I got to it, I proper fancied it. It looked really nice. I got a little bit of room. I got a little bit of open water to my left and an island to my right. And I thought, it looks lovely. But everyone who I spoke to, Jamie Hughes, Andy Bennett, said, don't fancy it at all, you won't catch much at all. So you'll catch a few to start with, and it'll just get worse and worse, and it won't be very good. But I kept my hopes up, because they were an odd fish topping at the start. I really, honestly, I really, really fancied it. And It was pretty much Harvey said. I didn't catch out to start with, really. And then the middle part of the match I caught really well on chopworm across to the island. A few fish shallow and a few fish on the bottom, down the middle, on casters. And then last hour everything died again. And I wonder if, because it gets fished a lot, Partridge, if they just sort of backed away. But I ended up with £89 again. And it was enough for only second in the section. Steve Openshaw had £100, a little bit further round. And I think I was third on Covey one with that. But we didn't win any money. But I learned quite a lot about that fishing across, you know. An interesting thing that I found that day was how important it was to fish in the right depth of water. Like, at first I started fishing right tight across, and I got an odd indication and odd bite. But felt like there were some fish to catch over there, but I couldn't catch them, so I just pulled it back on, moved my float up a few inches, come back away from that bank a little bit into a little bit deeper water, and had a really good run of fish. And for the rest of the match, I just alternated, and it were only sort of 6 or 8 inches difference in depth, but made a difference how much you got. So I felt like I learnt a lot.
Brilliant. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Of course.
I'll tell you what, I could definitely go back to Partridge then. I really like the place. Obviously, full of big, clever fish.
Well, they have like 6 matches a week, so them fish are pressured by match anglers all the time, which is why we should say very well done to the match winner.
Absolutely, he did absolutely brilliantly. David Shires.
Yeah.
Awesome display.
Fantastic hair colour.
Well, yeah, maybe that holds him back a little bit, like it does you, but angling ability, phenomenal. And well done to him on the match win. Now, before we sign off tonight, I've got to ask you about something.
Fire away.
You have been seen on a canal
mm-hmm.
near Chesterfield and Worksop area.
Chesterfield and Worksop? Yeah. Nowhere near Chesterfield.
You were on the Chesterfield Canal at Worksop, which is good enough for me. But
yes.
And you were sighted with a maiden.
A maiden?
Now, what can you tell me about her?
I've been having secret fishing lessons. You know, I told you that I've had a bit of a confidence knock and not been doing very well.
Yeah.
Went on the internet and typed in female angling coaches.
Right.
From the Sheffield area.
Yes.
And this particular one popped up. So I booked a session with her.
It wasn't the only thing that popped up on that particular session,
no,
was it?
No,
really?
It wasn't.
Any down by the canal?
Mm. No, there's several things. A couple of voles popped up.
Right.
Out of the hole, a little rat appeared.
Anything else? A little rat appeared, did it?
Really? Chub.
Really?
Several chubs, some very
large. When was the last
chub.
Time you had a chub on by the canal?
I mean, I've had several chub on by the canal of late, and you can see a few pictures on the screen now.
They were.
In all seriousness, it was really good.
It was.
Went for a little pleasure session down the canal.
Then you went fishing after, didn't you? But no. Megan looks a fantastic guy. I know you're planning on entertaining around here next weekend, aren't you? That's what you sort of said to me the plan is. So, Megan, all I can say is make sure you bring some money because you've got no chance of getting this town breeder to pay for anything. So, that's my only piece of advice, and I think we should sign off on that now.
Fantastic. I want to get my own back.